Hi, my name is Wouter Emery and I'm the founder of AirShaper. In this third video in our series AirBus Talks, Julian Maldonado will explain how they used AirBus knowledge and tools to help optimize the race boats taking part in the America's Cup. Enjoy the interview.
You also mentioned that you were involved heavily in two America's Cup projects, which is in general a race on water, let's say, with very advanced boats. Maybe you can just in general describe what the race is about and then mention what the involvement of Airbus and yourself was in the project.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. For the people that is not used to the America's Cup competition, is the most oldest competition in the world, competition in the world. The name is coming because it was two boats, one American's boat against British boats around England's island, I think, and the winner was the America's boat. As you said, it's a race of the boat. We can say a parallel with the Formula One. It's exactly the same of Formula One for boats. So there are many technology, many money on it. There's quite complex technology that we put on the boat. So since the three America's Cup before, they start to flying using the flying boat. Okay, so using the foulings to lift. So as soon as we can lift the boat from the sea, the boat start to win a lot of speed, and it's the aerodynamics is becomes more important in this kind of design. And in the past, maybe the aerodynamics was important for the sails, we can say, but never over the platform as we did in the last America's Cup. For example, detached flow coming from the crew, or cavities on the boat, that we can bring our expertise from the cavities of the landing gear that we have, or detached flow that we know very well. So there are many aspects that we can bring our experience.
And it sounds fascinating because, like you say, before the boats used to stay on the water, and then the hulls, for example, they are all very streamlined in the direction of the boat because that's the way they cut through the water. But as soon as they lift above the water, they have to take into account the angle of attack of the wind. So it's not no longer the hull in the direction of the wind, it's actually the wind coming from a side angle of attack. So we may be seeing innovative shapes in the future where they also take into account the aerodynamics effect of the hull, for example. Yes, that was probably a challenge for you.
Mm-hmm. The most challenge that we had that was sharing with the team of Oracle Team USA at that time was to get the drag of the trampoline. You know that the catamaran has a trampoline where the crew is going from the one side to the other. So if you can see the boat in details, the air is coming through beneath of the boat and going through the net or the trampoline. On the other challenge was we received three different platform shapes and what is the best platform in terms of the drag. Or we test different crew position. If you check out in the internet, you can see that the team New Zealand is using the cycling crew with a cycling helmet, and the position was very low to reduce the drag.
And I can imagine if you study something like the net, it's not just the drag of the net, it's also the impact that the net has on the flow quality that then impacts parts that come later in the boat, further downstream, for example.
Completely agree. And you can see, if you can see the design of the boat at that time, the catamaran, you have the front beam, the central platform, and the rear beam. So you need to find out a balance of all the forces, aerodynamic forces of the platform. And we found out a huge detachment on the rear part of the boat that we need to reduce. And you use, for example, the VGs.
So that was it for this third video in our series AirBus Talks. Stay tuned for the next and final video of the series, where Julian will explain some more inside details on the design of America's Cup boats and how they will help Team American Magic for the 36th edition of the America's Cup. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye-bye.